Welcome back. Problem 5.106. This problem is taken from chapter number 5, Analysis and Design of Beam for Bending, and the book name is Mechanics of Material by Beer and Johnston, 6th edition. And the topic that we are covering is Singularity Function or Michaelis Method. So statement is, using the Singularity Function, write the equation for shear and bending moment for the beam and loading shown. And in part B, determine the maximum value of bending moment in the beam. So you can see this is a simply supported beam having pin support at point C and roller support at point D, and there is a uniformly distributed load of 1500 newton per meter over the entire length of the beam. So you have to find the shear force and bending moment equation by using singularity function. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that if you remove this pin support at point C, so you'll be having a reaction force that is represented as RC, and if you remove this roller support, so you will be having a reaction force which is equal to RD, and this load is 1500 newton per meter, so we will write it as 1.5 kilo newton per meter, and this when converted into a point load, so it will be equal to 1.5 times the length over which it acts. So length is 2.4 plus 0.8 plus 0.8 is equal to 4. So this load will become equal to 6 kilo newton, and that will act at a distance of 2 from either side, either from A or from B. This distance is 2 meter. Now we'll find this RC and RD by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all moment about point D is equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point D, first moment is due to this RC. So RC into perpendicular distance is this 2.4, and it is producing clockwise moment, so it will be negative. So I will write minus RC multiply by 2.4. The second moment about point D is equal to this load, which is 6 kilo newton load, and perpendicular distance is this, which is equal to 2.4 divided by 2, which is 1.2, and it is producing counterclockwise moment, so this will be positive. So I will write it as plus 6 into 1.2 is equal to 0. So here we will get 2.4 RC will be equal to 7.2, and from here we will get this RC will be equal to 7.2 divided by 2.4 will give you 3 kilo newton. Now we'll find this RD by using another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to 0 and upward force is taken as positive. So RC is upward, 3 minus this 6 kN is downward, plus RD is equal to 0. So from here we will get RD will be also equal to 3 kN. Now we have both this RC and RD, so I will write it over here. This is RC because we will use it. This is 3 kN, and you have RD which is also equal to 3 kN. So by using singularity function, now we will define the shear force equation and bending moment diagram. So I will write first shear force equation by using singularity function. So you can see this is the loading shown, this is the shear force and bending moment diagram, and you can see that we will start from the left hand side and we will move towards the right hand side, and at the end we are right at the end of right hand side we will neglect the load. Okay, so starting from this 3 kilo newton, since this is a point load, so this is the diagram for the point load, and the shear force equation is this one. Since this load is downward and acting at a distance of A, so its shear force equation is minus P into X minus A power 0. So I will write the shear force equation for this one. Vx is equal to this load is upward, so this P will be positive here, and that P is 3 kilonewton. So 3 into x minus A. So A over here will be equal to x minus 8, because A for this load is 0.8. So minus 0.8, and you can see the power is 0. The second load is this one, which is also 3 kilonewton. So upward. So again, this will be positive 3 into x minus. Now the A for this will be equal to this total distance, which is 2.4 plus 0.8, and that is equal to 3.2 meters. So I will write x minus 3.2 power 0, and we have a distributed load of 1.5 kilonewton per meter over the entire length. So for distributed load, you can see the shear force equation is this one. So since W is downward here, so W it is negative. So I will write minus WW is 1.5. You can check it over here, and it is acting from the start. So A will be equal to 0 for this. So it will be Vx minus 0 power 1. So I can write the shear force equation is minus 1.5x, this term first, plus 3 into x minus 0.8 power z is 0.8 power 0 plus 3 into x minus 3.2 power 0. So this is the equation number 1, which is the required shear force equation using singularity function. Now we will find bending moment equation by using singularity function. How we'll find this? So start again, we will start M of X. Now for distributed load 1.5 kilonewton, so you can see for distributed load that is shown over here, the equation of bending moment is this one. Since W is downward, so I will write this equation is minus 1 over 2 W naught is 1.5 into X minus A. A is 0 because distributed load starts from point A, so A is equal to 0. So it is power 2. Now the second load is this. Three kilonewton load. So that is upward. So for bending moment equation for the point load will be this one. Since this is for the downward load, so upward load will be plus P is 3 into x minus 0.8 power 1. And for this load, it will be again plus 3 into x minus 0. A is equal to 3.2 for this load. So 3.2 power 1. So if you simplify this, so moment equation will be equal to minus 1.5 divided by 2 is minus 0.75 x square plus 3 into x minus 0.8 power 1 plus 3 into x minus 3.2 power 1. And this equation number 2 is the required bending moment equation using singularity function. Now we will move toward part B, and in part B it is given that determine the maximum value of bending moment in the beam. So what we will do is that for part B, we know that maximum bending moment occurs where shear force equal to 0, and this will occur at x is greater than 0.8 meter, we will see, and it will be less than 3.2 meter. And this x will act at a point which we say that this is point E. So it will be somewhere in this region. The shear force will be maximum. So what we will do is that put x is equal to xe is equal to 3.2 meter. sorry, put V is equal to 0, because we are finding this XE where shear bending moment is maxima in equation number 1. Equation number 1 is this one. So V is equal to 0 is equal to 1 minus 1.5 into, it will be XE plus 3 into XE minus 0.8 power 0 plus 3 into X minus 3.2 power 0. Now you can see that X is less than 3.2. So if you put X is less than 3.2, this will be a negative value, and any value that is negative inside this Macaulay bracket will be considered as 0. So we will write this equation will be equal to minus 1.5 XE plus 3 into X minus XE minus 0.8 power 0. And this term is anything power 0 is 1. So we will get 0 is equal to 1.5 XE plus 3 into 1, which is 3. So I can write it 1.5 time XE is equal to 3, and we will get XE will be equal to 2 meter. Okay. Now just put this value XE in this equation, which I will write it over here. This moment equation was, equation 2 was M of X is equal to minus 0.75 X square plus 3 into X minus 0.8 power 1 plus 3 into X minus 3.2 power 1. This was equation number 2. So put XE is equal to 2 meter in equation number 2. So you will get moment about point E is equal to maximum moment, and that is equal to minus 0.75 times 2 square plus 3 into 2 minus 0.8 power 1 plus 3 into 2 minus 3.2 power 1. So I will get minus 0.75 multiplied by 4 plus, this will give you 3 into 1.2 power 1 plus, this value is negative, so any value that is negative inside Macaulay bracket will be considered as 0. So I can write this maximum bending moment or moment at point E will be equal to 0.6 kilo Newton, or you can also say that maximum bending moment is 600 Newton into meter, which is the answer of our this question. Again, you can check it. We can also check it at various point. We can check when you put at X is equal to 0.8 meter in equation number 2. When you put it, you will get moment about point C, because C is at a distance of 0.8. So you will get moment about point C is minus 0.480 kilonewton into meter, or that is equal to minus 480 newton into meter. Similarly, at X is equal to 3.2 meter, we will get moment about point D, because you can see D is at a distance of 3.2 meter from point A. So moment about D is also minus 0.480 kilonewton into meter, which is minus 480 newton into meter. So at point C we have 480 newton into meter, at point D 480 newton into meter, and at a distance of 2 meter at point E, which is in this region of CD, we have maximum bending moment, or that is in the middle, because this point is 1.2 clear plus this is 1.2 meter and this is 0.8. So at the middle of this beam we have maximum bending moment, which is 600 newton into meter. And that was all about this problem 5.106. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you are learning as well. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.